Hi everyone, I'm Jeremy for Real, and today I am going to be talking about some characters from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure that a lot of the fandom seems to generally hate, but I don't find that bad, and actually like. I've numbered them from numbers 5 to 1, as in the 5th is seemingly the least hated out of the bunch, and 1's the most hated. Quick note, these are just my personal opinions, so if you don't like the characters in this video, that's cool, I don't mind, but if you like them, that's awesome. I hope you like the video either way. A quick possible spoiler warning for parts 3 and 5, but definitely 4, just to be sure, just in case any of you haven't seen those parts yet. With that disclaimer out of the way, let's start the video. At number 5 is Manish Boy, or Death 13. While a lot of people don't necessarily seem to care about him, some people do avidly dislike him. I suppose he seems kind of unneeded and just a filler character, as are a lot of the enemy stand users in Stardust Crusaders, but that's another topic for another time. However, I don't think that's the reason people dislike him. He's rather sadistic, seemingly loving to torture his victims, and he even laughs with that certain laugh that a stand Death 13 does when he's in the act. However, even while doing this, he still somehow acts in a childish manner, given he is technically only 11 months old and is a baby. While a lot of people could be repelled by the sadism alone, or even mixed with the childishness which makes it even more unnerving, I found his character funny. The irony of him having an overall good strategy and being almost genius-like while being a baby is just funny to me. Also, some of his best lines, "I may crap my diaper, but I'm still smarter than you," or something along that line. I'm actually sorry for that. If you want to leave a dislike on this video, that's completely fair and I totally understand. Those types of lines were just funny, like, what? It was really unnecessary, but still hilarious. Like, come on, you could have just said that you were a baby. Anyway, summary, his character was funny to me, and it was amusing to watch. Also, the fangs, that was pretty cool. He looked like a little devil baby dude. Alright, on to number 4 is Anne, or Runaway Girl. Anne is actually one of my favorite characters from Stardust Crusaders. I like how they let her tag along and just kind of hang out for a while. Anyway, Anne is a rather self-important and feisty girl. When first meeting the Crusaders, she was literally willing to take on all of them. 5-6 plus feet tall men, except for Cocky when he's 5'10", dressed bizarrely. Can you imagine? She's maybe 4 or 5 feet tall. At one point, she even tries to get all the attention by commenting on her growth, but to no avail, as no one cares. A lot of people can find this annoying, which I completely get. I still like her, though. She's brave to the point it's foolish, jumping from the boat to swim to shore, not to mention how she wanted to fight the Crusaders like we talked about earlier. She's talkative, but deep down, I think she has a good heart. I don't know, maybe that's just what I think. Possibly I relate to her in the way that I'm kind of annoying sometimes and I'm a bit of an attention hog. But I still wish there were more people who liked Anne out there. Uh-oh. Number 3, the crazy doctor, Chocolata. Oh boy, here we go. What are some words? Kind, caring, regretful, and sweet are some words that do not describe the sex doctor. Wait, that isn't fair. He did show guilt and regret when he threw Seko's sugar cubes too far. Anyway, he is the clear definition of a sadist, almost impossible to not hate him. Note that I said almost impossible. I like him as a character. I'm not going to go over the reasons why people dislike him, as I'm sure you can think of a couple off at the top of your head. I don't know what necessarily compels me to him. Maybe it's just that there aren't many characters that have personalities that are just like his. Sure, there are a lot of characters that are even a little sadistic to a decent amount, but as much as him, if you genuinely know, comment it down below. As you'll see from this number as well as the next, you may come to find out that I have a knack for loving characters that are absolutely terrible people and have no redeeming qualities whatsoever. Here it is, number 2. Truly the lowest scum in history, Steely Dan. Before I start, I just want to apologize. I'm extremely sorry from the bottom of my heart. I don't know why I like this man, I really don't. Feel free to skin me alive, I get it. Steely Dan is absolutely despisable to the point where Rocky, the literal creator of the character, gave him one of the longest beatdowns in the entire series. He punched a child for hitting him with a broom, he made Jotaro steal things and then made it so the shop owner would see so he'd get in trouble, he used him as a bridge, killed Enya with no mercy, and when Jotaro hesitated one bit to do one of the heinous acts he told him to do, he would either mildly hurt himself so Joseph would feel the pain but 10 times worse, or hit Jotaro who could do absolutely nothing about it. There's literally nothing redeemable he does, and all of his actions are completely terrible. He is no doubt one of the most hated characters in the franchise, and rightfully so. Now, what you've all been waiting for. Here he is. Number one, Speedwagon. No, I'm kidding. It's Shigechi. Let's see. Shigechi. Wow. Came in as a nice, albeit naive kid, and went out as a kid who simply wanted to protect his parents. Sure, in between he was not great and was rather selfish and greedy. The thought of him sharing the yen prize that he, Josuke, and Okuyasu got together did not fit well with him, so much that he absolutely refused to share it and used Harvest to help him escape. He was extremely close to getting away with all of the money himself, but he was baited with more by Okuyasu. I personally believe that he shouldn't be hated, as he was just a child, and what prompted his anger was being called an idiot when the three of them were initially on the same side. Honestly, I kind of like his character. Selfish and greedy, sure, but in the end, he was just a kid who wanted to protect his parents in the town. I feel like I don't have enough time to go into depth about this, so I'm probably going to make another video that actually goes into it and talks and explains more. I know I'm not going to get a lot of views on this, but if you guys are interested in that, just let me know. And that's the end of the video. If you actually made it this far, thank you so much. If you like this, why not subscribe? I don't have a catchy thing to say after the subscribe thing like most YouTubers do, so yeah. If you have any suggestions for videos for me to make, preferably JoJo, because I don't really watch much else, leave a comment down below, and I'll consider it. A quick side note, if I sounded like kind of awkward in the middle of this, or like in some parts, sorry, and just a bit nervous, I guess. I guess that's all I have to say. See ya!